When you look at markets overall, we saw a little bit of a sell-off in the last couple of days. There was not really warranted by anything. I guess it's fear on the markets, it's looking at trade and other things. How do you see that developing?
No, I think what was going on now is that some of the sectors that benefit from this kind of strong growth, especially in the U.S., that are a bit under pressure. We are starting to see the first impact on tariffs also on U.S. earnings. Global growth is weaker. Global tightening is a fact. And I think the expectation were a bit too high, and now we are just see an adjustment to a lower level. But it's not the end of the bull market, in our view. But I think it's not just technical. It's a correction that is more fundamental, I think. And all these challenges will not go away very easily.
Okay, what do you think, where do you see the most value? So if you say it's not the end of the bull market, what will be the end of the bull market?
Well, the end of the bull market will be a U.S. recession. I think that this is not going to happen in the next 12 months, maybe in 2020. The problem is that everybody seems to be expecting a recession in 2020. I think as long as the U.S. economy is growing at 2 or 3%, I think the market will continue to rise. We are going to see more volatility, more corrections. And I have to say, though, if you look at valuations now, even for stocks, industrial stocks in the U.S., we are almost the same level of the end of 2009. So I think there may be some upside on valuation, and sentiment is very depressed. So we may see a short-term bounce from here.